Hello, I'm Dr. Ron Eaglin, and I'm going to get you started using jQuery. And first, what is jQuery? Well, jQuery is a JavaScript library, which is written in JavaScript. You can have direct access to the code of jQuery that makes it really easy to do other things in JavaScript. And the reason that jQuery is such a popular language, is popular to use, is because the ease of which it lets programmers that use JavaScript do different things. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to show you a little bit of jQuery. First take you to the jQuery site here. If I go directly to the jQuery, right here, jQuery.com is the jQuery site. You can download the jQuery JavaScript. You can connect to the JavaScript directly from your code, from your HTML code in a content, in a CDN or a content developer network, which basically means you don't have to download it, but you can still use it. And there's a lot of information about jQuery at the jQuery.com site. I'm going to kind of take you through in a number of lectures how to use jQuery though. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to bring over here a little edited jQuery that I have right here. And first, I'm going to show you the code, and this is the whole code. All right, and then I'm going to take you back, and I'm going to say, well, what does this code do? So I'm just going to load it, and this is simple. If I go to this links and I click on it, I get an alert that says clicked on an H1, and then actually, see those are two anchors down here. If I hover over the anchor, it's going to give me this hovered on an anchor as an alert. So I was able to do both those things. And both of those anchors will actually do this. So if I hover over one, okay, I have hovered on an anchor, okay. And if I actually click the anchor, okay, if I'm fast enough to click on the anchor, it'll actually work just like an anchor. Well, let's see how this whole thing worked. Over here in my code for this same page, I have a standard page, HTML, a head, a body. And if you look at this, the most important thing that I have right now is this connection to jQuery.js. What I've done is I have loaded the jQuery JavaScript into the same directory that I have the jQuery one. So jQuery.js is loaded here with this. And if you want to know, you know, get some more information about this, I can actually look at the jQuery.js file. It is written right there. It's just JavaScript, and you can look at the full JavaScript of how jQuery works. Now right now we're just going to learn a little bit about using jQuery, so I'm going to take you through some of the steps of using jQuery. Now I'm going to write a script here within the script tags that utilizes jQuery, and the first thing that's really important here is this little piece of code right here. $ in a parentheses, then an object, and then close parentheses, and that's the jQuery selector. What the jQuery selector does is it allows you to select an object, and actually allows you to select multiple objects, and in this case the object that I'm selecting is the document. So document is an object that is already built into JavaScript and built into HTML pages. And what I'm going to do is when this object, the document, is ready, basically meaning that when ready is triggered, it means that the document has actually loaded into the browser and the DOM, the document object model, is accessible and ready to be used. So when this happens, I'm going to call a function. Okay, this is saying that I have a function that's going to allow me to do and register specific events within these parentheses. Now, if you notice here, the parentheses for this function is the open brackets and close brackets, and I have code in here that I want to be able to execute when the document, the DOM, is loaded into the browser. Okay, so let's see what I actually tell it to do. So, in this little chunk of code right here will likely be in pretty much every jQuery that you, when you use jQuery code, will likely be in every piece of jQuery that you write. OK, Okay, so let's look a little bit more at what I'm going to do here. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to use the selector again. Remember, the selector. And in this case, the selector is going to select A. What this does is it selects all of the A tags in the document. So basically all of the anchors. Now, the way I've written it right now, it selects all the anchors, but I could easily tell it to select a specific anchor. I could tell it to select something by the ID. I have the ability of using the selector, which is basically changing what is inside of those parentheses so that I can select anything in my document. I have even the ability to do some types of queries to allow me to select specific things within the document. Okay, I'm going to say this one more time because this is extremely important in using jQuery. The selector allows you to select different objects in your document, and it has the ability to make it very easy to select all of a specific type of object, one specific type of object, select by name, select by type, select by query. But the bottom line is that this returns a jQuery object. Okay, so that return is a jQuery object. Because this returns an object, I can now use the dot notation. So, in this case, I've selected all of the anchor tags, and then the dot hover allows me to do something when that dot hover is triggered. Okay, now in this case, I'm going to call a function, and the function is just simply going to have the code hovered on an anchor brought up in an alert. I also did the same thing, and this time I selected all of the H1 tags. Now I only have one, but I'm going to select all of them, and this time the action is dot, or basically this is a property, we would call it a property, but dot click, and again I have a function, and this function in the brackets here, I'm going to call an alert this time also. So that when I run this code, when I bring it over here and I operate it, and I run it, remember I selected all of the H1 tags. This, by the way, that links is in an H1 tag. If I click on it, I have clicked on an H1. And then I had the hover for this other one. I'm going to go into this code and I'm going to make one little change right here to the code here. Instead of making this hover, I'm going to change it to click, just so I can demonstrate. And I'll change this to clicked on an anchor, because those are anchor tags. And then here's the H1s that are being selected and the anchors that are being selected. That's what you see on the page. Okay, I'll save this. Okay, I'll come back over here and reload it. Again, I have clicked on an H1. Now if I click on the jQuery, I get clicked on an anchor, and then it should go to the jQuery site. So it basically executes the code that is what an anchor normally does. But notice I got that right here, the clicked on an anchor. And I did it on both of those anchors. So the purpose of this is to get you ready to use the concept of a selector and get started in using jQuery. Okay, we're going to have some more lectures on jQuery, but I'm going to stress again the important aspects of jQuery for this lecture. One is you have to link to the script for jQuery, which means that you either will download it or link to it at another site. Okay, and you'll set the source equal to jquery.js or whatever the name of the file is that you downloaded that has the jQuery. I took the version name out of this file name and just named it jquery.js. Okay, I have the ability to use the selector to check to see if the document is ready, and then set up so that these events could be triggered, or basically these objects can be created once the document is ready. It's important that you have this after the DOM is loaded, because these objects, the anchor and the H1, don't exist prior to the loading of the document object model, which happens when you load a browser. Then I set it up so that this object would respond when you had a click by calling a function. In this case, the function is simply alert. Say clicked on an anchor. Okay, and then the same thing here, an alert. There's a lot of different things that I could do in here, but these were very straightforward, simple examples and demonstrated how the whole thing came together. But the important part of this lecture is the concept of the selector. Now, if you want to learn more about how I can do much more complex things with selectors, simply go to the documentation for jQuery, okay? And the jQuery documentation will take you all through selectors and how to use selectors to do everything. So you have a lot of different ways, such as attribute contains word, not equal, a lot of different ways to select specific objects on the page. Once you've selected an object on the page, then you have a tremendous amount of capability of manipulating those objects. And we'll cover some of that in later lectures. So hopefully I've got enough to get you started with looking at jQuery and just a basic understanding of that concept of the jQuery selector and moving on so that you can do more with jQuery. Thank you very much and good programming.